Buckles exercises every day and has always known he'd live past 100.
It's something that you have to work on. It isn't just easy.
What do you do to work on it?
Well, when you think you're going to die, don't. You see, I've known about exercise all my life. When I was a boy in Missouri, I always lived upstairs, halfway on the stairway I put up a bar, and I'd have to jump to get a hold of it. I'd chin myself so many times, do that when I was a boy.
Buckles can no longer drive the tractor and do the heavy labor that farming requires, but for most of his life, Buckles has been very active.
I was going to exercise to physical therapy over in Martinsburg, and I always drove myself. I did that until, I guess it's 102.
Wow.
And then I got to, and Susanna would come down on Tuesdays. I sure owe a lot to Susanna.
I am very blessed with, as old as he is, that his constitution is very good. He has generally very good health. He doesn't have any major problems.
Flanagan says her father has become a celebrity of sorts in his old age. She says interest in him has grown because there are so few World War I veterans left. Flanagan finds herself managing a schedule that includes media interviews and requests for information, pictures, and autographs.
We get school children from elementary, middle school, high school, college, people who are writing papers, people who are collectors. Some are World War I collectors, some are military collectors, some are autograph collectors, just famous people.
Today, Mr. Buckles spends his time enjoying his farm, his daughter's company, and all the fond memories from a lifetime that was often filled with adventure.
I know that most of them retain some fascinating stories, but I try to remember the things that are interesting to me.
Have you enjoyed living here at Gapview?
Here?
Yeah.
Yes, sure. I'm not very active now, but it has been interesting for me.
Why?
Oh, why? Because I make it interesting, I guess.
This story was produced as part of our series, Aging with Grace and Dignity. Last week, Senator Robert Byrd recognized Frank Buckles on the Senate floor. The 89-year-old Byrd noted he was just a pup when Buckles served in World War I, and that he was mighty proud one of the four remaining survivors is a hale and hearty West Virginian.